Dear learners, I hope you are all doing fine. I welcome you all to the class where we are going to have the general information about our DP8 English course. We have two different parts here, and they are namely subject knowledge SK and pedagogical knowledge PK. And today I am Ishtiaq Ahmed, Instructor General PTI Sirajganj with you. In this class, we will discuss about introduction to SK and PK for DP8 English, characteristics and components of DP8 English SK, and characteristics and components of DP8 English PK. First, we are going to get introduced with the DP8 English subject knowledge. This is the part where learners will get knowledge of English. The course is designed to develop trainee teachers in teaching English of the primary schools of Bangladesh. This course intended to develop the communicative skills of our trainee teachers. And the emphasis has been given on the functional language having relevance to classroom teaching and primary school textbooks. That means English for today. And this time we are getting introduced with the DP8 English PK. This is the part where learners will learn how to teach English. The expectation from this course is to develop teachers' skill for teaching English in the primary schools of Bangladesh effectively. The course is interactive and participatory in nature and intended to develop the communicative skills of our trainee teachers as well as our students. Emphasis has been given on the functional language having relevance to classroom teaching and primary school textbooks. That means English for today. Now we are going to see what are the characteristics and components of English SK, that means subject knowledge part. First, the objectives. The objectives of this course are to improve trainees' own English language skills. That means listening, speaking, reading, and writing skills. To improve their pronunciation, stress, and intonation skills. To enhance their ability to use grammatical structures appropriately. To expand trainee teachers' vocabulary and to achieve communicative competencies. Now we will learn about the expected learning outcomes of English SK. By the end of the course, the trainee teachers will have listened to spoken English at a level appropriate to teaching English throughout the primary level. Spoken English for a range of purposes, including their classroom teaching role. Read English, text, rhymes, poems, stories, newspapers, etc. written in English for a range of purposes. Identify the factors which facilitate English language learning. Demonstrated understanding those aspects of English which are particularly challenging to Bangla-speaking learners. Explained how to apply the learned skills and experiences in their classroom practice and shown their development of language skills using ICT. So, this is the content summary of characteristics and components of DP8 English subject knowledge. Here, we have a total of 12 units and a total of 28 lessons, where we will learn about critical thinking, practice of four language skills, grammar with the main language point practice, and language practice with the real life situations. This time, we are going to learn about the characteristics and components of DP8 English pedagogical knowledge, that means PK. First, the objectives. The objectives of this course are to acquaint the trainee teachers with the primary English curriculum, to equip the trainee teachers with CLT method to plan, teach, and assess primary English curriculum effectively, and to develop the ability to use different child-centric methods and activity-based techniques according to the needs of diverse learners. To develop skills to prepare and use appropriate materials and technologies, including ICT, in teaching English. To develop skills and ability to carry out action research for professional development and English teaching improvement. And to enhance participants' knowledge of teaching, which meets and goes beyond the immediate demands of the national curriculum. This time, we are going to learn about the expected learning outcomes of DPED English pedagogical knowledge. After this course, the trainee teachers will be able to demonstrate the understanding of competencies of primary English curriculum, use CLT method and techniques to enhance students' ability to express their own ideas in English, to use a variety of interactive teaching strategies, including peer learning and technologies, to involve all the students as active learners, to apply classroom management principles for involving learners in their learning process, to plan appropriate and progressive lessons and sequences of lessons by using English content knowledge, to administer the different learning styles of diverse learners and bring out best outcome of it, to develop and apply formative and summative assessment tools for the primary language learning in and out of the classroom, to prepare, collect, use and preserve teaching aids effectively, and to administer teaching of NCTB textbooks in English in primary schools. Here is the content summary of DPED English pedagogical knowledge. Here we have total of 13 units and a total of 31 lessons. The key features of these sections are critical and reflective thinking, variety of techniques, real life situation, problems and problem solving, combination of small group works, case studies, debates, role plays, micro teaching, simulations, etc. So, my dear learners, what have we learned today? We learned about what is SK and PK, aims and objectives of SK and PK of DPED English, characteristics of SK and PK of DPED English, and the key features of English subject knowledge and pedagogical knowledge for DPED English. Dear learners, I think from today's class you have got a general idea of the DPED English book with both of the parts, that means SK and PK. Now, I suggest you all to take your resource English book in hand and have a close look in line with the information you have just got in my class. And please stay home and stay safe. And please don't forget to keep learning. For the day, it's time to say goodbye.